Hey, my name is Jack and this is the third part of my tutorial series explaining how L systems work in animation nodes. Last time I showed you that text replacement is a fundamental part of how L systems work and that even with only one rule you can create fairly complex objects. This time we want to take it one step further by creating an L system that uses multiple rules. Let's start by creating a system that creates just a straight line, but that grows with the number of generations. So you usually do that by using a symbol variable, for example a, and then use the rule a equal to fa. So in the beginning there's only an a and this will draw nothing, and in generation 1 the a is replaced by fa. So we get one segment. When we go to generation 2, we get another F, because in generation 1 there is this A, and when we go to generation 2, this A is replaced by FA, so we get two Fs now. And this will get larger and larger the more generations we have. Now let's make this a bit more interesting by creating a branch at every point. So if we would do it by hand, we could do it like that. First go one step up, then create a branch, go to the right, end the branch, then go one step up again, create another branch, end the branch, go one step up, and so on. But now we want to make that more procedurally so that it can grow. And we will do that by using an A again here, and instead of just replacing A with FA, we will also create a branch here, turn it to the right, and start this branch. So now when we increase the number of generations, you see that we get exactly the effect I showed you before, just that it can grow. That looks quite cool already. Right, now we can make this a bit more interesting by letting these secondary branches grow as well. To do that, I will do a very similar technique. So I will replace this F with an B. And now we can do the same thing again. We'll just replace the B by an F and another B. So now you can look here at the string. First it goes one step up, then it creates a new branch, turns it to the right, then goes forward multiple times, ends the branch, and so on. So now we get this effect. We can make this even more interesting by introducing some rotation. So at the moment all these points are on a straight line, but we might want to rotate them so that they go like this. Right, we can do that by using the pitch up operator in that case. I will just insert it here, for example, it doesn't really matter. For now the angle is 90 degrees by default. We could change it here, but that would also change the angle of the plus operator. So I will leave that at 90 and type it in manually here, like for example 5 degrees, or let's use 10. Now you can see that these lines go in a circle. Right, we can make the individual line segments a bit shorter by telling the L system to only go 0.2 steps for each generation forward. And I will make this one a bit shorter as well, for example 0.1. Now everything is a bit smaller. Nice. So now we want to have some more randomness, and to do that we can use another functionality a system provide, which are probabilities of rules. So for example, I can give this probability, this rule a probability of 50%. That means that in every generation, this rule has a 50% chance of being used for every B. That means that the different branches will grow at a different velocity. So we get some more variation. Because this rule is not executed for every B anymore, we can use another rule that also uses the B and create something different. For example, we could tell it to go five step forward, and we want only that this rule is used in 1% of the times. So now, whenever this rule is used for a B, it creates a straight line and stops there. We can do it so that the circle creation continues at that point by typing a B here again. So when we go that far, it will just use the first rule for B most of the time. It might make sense to use not a visible straight line, but an invisible by changing the uppercase left to a lowercase f. Now we get this effect. I will also increase the probability of this rule to 5%, and now we get this fairly good looking result. Right. Last thing for now, I want to show you how to create a mesh that can be rendered, because at the moment these are all just edges. Unfortunately, there is no perfect way to do it, but we can use an operator, a node called edge2tube, which will just replace every edge with a small cylinder. And to use that, we can use the mesh info node to get the individual vertices and edge indices, and use the generated mesh as output. And that looks a bit clunky. Let's make it a bit smaller. So yeah, here you can see how it looks. Note that increasing the resolution now creates much more geometry. Can also turn off the caps because they are not really necessary here. And yeah, that's it for now. See you later.